Hello, welcome to another Facebook Friday. It's another Free Lychee Friday. I'm back after an awesome weekend away. The weather was not our friend for sure. And the joke was basically when we went away last weekend, you know, this weekend is going to be like sunny and beautiful and perfect. And it is, although last Friday was really nice too. So this Friday is beautiful, but I think all weekends are going to be beautiful. And that's just how it goes. So yeah, we went up to Mackinac Island for the big 50th birthday celebration. So yeah, we had just a great time. Honestly, it kind of didn't matter that the weather wasn't so great. Hey Barb, how are you? Glad you can join us. We went rafting actually on Friday when it was nice. So that was very cool up north on a pretty serious river. It wasn't like whitewater rafting, but we had to do some steering and there was a lot of like, you know, leaning way back as like you're going underneath, you know, branches that are like over the water. So, hey, Sally, hello. So that was fun. And then we went out for dinner Friday night up in Mackinac City, which is where we stayed. We tried to stay on the island, but it's so expensive. And we had a bunch of us. We wanted a few different rooms. So we actually got this huge like suite kind of thing, and it had three different bedrooms and a sitting area and a couple bathrooms all kind of in one big area. So it worked out really well in Mackinac City. We did that. So yeah, and then in November, Barb. Oh my gosh, good for you. I know these like milestone birthdays. 40 I don't even remember really like worrying much about, but 50 I've kind of been like, I mean, not really, I don't know, whatever. Age is just, it is what it is, right? But so yeah, so then actually Saturday morning we got up, and of course it was totally raining because it was going to be 100% chance of rain basically. Hey Philomena. But we were like, okay, we're just not worrying about it. My sister brought ponchos for everybody to wear. Hey Diana. So we got to the ferry, got on the ferry. Everybody's all bundled up in their like masks and their ponchos. We get off the ferry on Mackinac Island and it's raining. Like, what are we gonna do now, right? My idea was like, we're gonna rent bikes and ride all over the island. Well, who wants to ride bikes in like the kind of pouring rain, right? So we decided, we like literally walked off of the ferry and we're like, oh, carriage rides, like these huge, like, I don't know how many rows that could fit probably like four adults. I don't know, seven or eight rows, like a huge carriage, these huge workhorses too that are pulling the carriage. There are no like motorized vehicles other than like maybe a police car and an ambulance, I think, on the island. There's very, very little motorized vehicle situation if you haven't been to Mackinac Island. So these huge workhorses pulling us like kind of around the island. And we learned so much on this carriage tour. I've never done one of those before. Usually, like I said, we hop on our bikes and just kind of do our own thing. And I enjoy like seeing nature and, you know, kind of everything that the island has to offer. But we learned a ton. And actually there was one stop that we made that they told us about, kind of like these steps that you could take up to the highest point on Mackinac Island, to not like Fort Mackinac, but another fort that I'm drawing a blank on my name of. Anyway, so after we did the whole carriage tour, we're like, hey, let's go back and find where you can hike up those steps. So we did that, and actually wasn't raining at that point. So that was awesome, just to be able to kind of wander around and kind of see the island. Not as much maybe as we would have otherwise, but hello, Miss Teresa. So, but it worked out perfectly. We met up with some other friends that just like randomly happened to be on the island that day, and had to have a cocktail with them, a little birthday cocktail, and then just went back to Mackinac City and had a nice evening together, and then came back home on Sunday. So anyway, it was wonderful. It was great to be away. So yeah, just refreshing to do something new and different, right? So thank you guys all, as I'm like babbling on and on about that. So let's get to like our stamping fun, right? So we have our product of the week. Have you guys been enjoying this? The Love of Leaves bundle, right? So awesome stamp set with some fun like leaf imagery. Great sentiments too. Let's take a look at those. So we've got Hope Changes Everything. Can I get that in view? I Thought of You Today. Love that one. Thank You. There's a little baby. Hello. Your Friendship Is Something I Know I Can Count On. And I'm So Glad You're In My Life. And then my most favorite part about this bundle are the dies, the stitched leaves dies. Maybe I turn them that way so you can see. This one I think looks like a city, right? Like you could make it like, you know, like a city outline, right? And then the stitching on all of these leaves too. So the one outside edge die cuts, and the inside one just does the stitching. So put them together and you die cut and stitch, or you could do just one or just the other. So Awesome, I love anything that has stitching on it. We're all just in love with that, right? And these especially are fabulous. So we've got great stuff. I'm gonna be showing you some fun projects. Actually, my class to go featured the Love of Leaves bundle also. So actually, maybe I'll even just say that right now. Quick reminder, I'll show you. These are the four cards that you can make in the Love of Leaves class to go, right? Is that one? Yeah, that's going right here. Anyway, so this class to go though, RSVPs are due next Friday, which is September 25th, okay? So if you're interested in that, I'll have the link with all of the details. Hello, Susan. I'm always like so visual, right? So if you're watching the Facebook Live video, if you look above it, after I do Facebook Live, I always edit and all the details are right in there. And one of them will be the link to that class to go for more information on that. If you're interested in getting that class to go, because I've got the one option with the bundle and then you get the designer series paper. I'm trying to remember now. I don't even have my notes, but you get the plaid tidings DSP. And you get, oh yeah, the ribbon, the beautiful, can you guys see if I get close up in there? That embroidered ribbon, I love that ribbon. With option number one. Option number two, you don't get the bundle, you have to have that though to do your stamping and your die cutting, right? Option number three is the PDF tutorial, and option four is anybody in my downline. So hello, Lisa in sunny Wisconsin, I know, don't we love that, right? It's sunny Michigan here too, or yes. Because the sun is going to be leaving us soon. Winter will be here before we know it. And it's not nearly as sunny then, is it? So we're enjoying, right? Enjoy the fall while we have it. So yeah, so class to go, RSVPs are due, payments due by next Friday. So you got another week if you're thinking about that. If you have any questions, let me know too, okay? A couple of other announcements, things I want to make sure that everybody knows about. So we are going to be having, excuse me, a designer series paper sale. It starts on October 1st, so you still got a couple weeks. Thank you for sharing too, Lisa. Sharing the video, I mean, sharing. Thank you always for sharing. Whatever you want to say, just share it with us too, right? So designer series paper sale. It starts October 1st, so we got a couple more weeks. And they're going to discount, I don't think it's all of it, but some paper in the annual catalog and some in the August to December, the holiday mini catalog. So watch out for that. That'll be coming October 1st, okay? And then another fun announcement, I just want to give you a little sneak peek of info on this celebration, which is our big promotion that we do where when you spend $50, you get to pick a free celebration item. Usually it goes like January, February, and March, and they're changing it up. So next year, going to be in January and February, so it's just 2 months, so not in March. And then they're going to do it again in the summer. They're going to do it in July and August of 2021 also. So that's very cool. Oh, Lily's home from school. She's been taking my car to school and I was like, hey, that looks like my car driving by. And then I realized, okay, she's pulling to the driveway. So she'll definitely be coming to say hello as she walks through here because she's really, really good at that these days. Isn't she, ladies? No, she'll probably crawl down below me or go in the other door so she doesn't have to walk by. You know, those teenagers, they're kind of funny like that these days. So what else? Oh, yeah, the starter kit promotion. So don't forget, guys, you get, let me make sure I get it right, you get the Queen Anne's Lace stamp set, you get the So Much Love stamp set, you get a pack of rhinestones, and then you get all the cardstock pieces cut, scored, ready to go to make 16 cards using those stamp sets. Plus, as always, you get to pick $125 in product, and you pay only $99 plus sales tax, no shipping fee on that starter kit. Hello, Teresa. Thank you for joining us. Awesome deal. It's now through September 30th, so you still got a little bit of time. Oh, Stormy's like, who's here? Hi, Lily.
Hi.
You want to come say hi to Facebook Live?
I think I'm all right.
Yeah, I called that, didn't I, ladies? I called that. Maybe you could at least wave as you walk by, right? Yeah, we'll see. She's going to play with Stormy. Actually, take him outside and go potty one more time, please. Okay, sorry. A little housekeeping there. So get the starter kit. It's an awesome, awesome deal. The idea was that, a lot of times people maybe want to either get friends and family together to make cards. Maybe you even want to do a class. So they're trying to give you those parts and pieces with card kits kind of all ready to go and the stamp sets. And then they even give you the step-by-step how to put the cards together. They give you actual cards that you can make with all your stuff in the starter kit. So it's just kind of an awesome way to kind of get that first step of getting together with people or, like I said, maybe even doing a class. So it's a a good kind of get over that first hurdle, that first step, which is sometimes hard for people to do, right? So awesome starter kit deal. I'd love to have you join our Inkspired Stampers group as well. We have an awesome group of ladies that love to stamp and share and have fun together. We have a separate Facebook group for our Inkspired Stampers, my downline group. We do meetings once a month. I do them live here in Alma, but then we can also hook up and we do them on Facebook Live too. So wherever you are, you can always feel like you're a part of things. So I've got lots of other great perks. We love to do creative challenges, swapping, love to reward you for moving along in promotions through the compensation plan. So lots of good reasons to join our Inkspired Stampers team. And if you have any questions, let me know, because I'd love to get you set up with the starter kit. And also, you get your name entered in my birthday drawing, the drawing we're doing all month long. You get an entry into the drawing. If you buy the starter kit, you could win a brand new Stampin Cut and Emboss Machine. So how about that, huh? So get that starter kit and maybe you could win the Stampin Cut Emboss Machine also. So, okay, I have so much I wanna show you guys and tell you guys about today. So I'm like talking even faster than I ever talk, right? And thank you for sharing, Susan, which leads me into my next, right? Sharing the video. If you share this video, or if you shared the last video that I did, your name is in the drawing right now to win the Absolutely Argyle Embossing Folder, this awesome, awesome folder right here, okay? So your name is in here. If you shared the video anytime between when I first posted back on September 4th was my last Facebook Live video, and last night at like midnight, your name is in here. Lily, oh no, she's teasing, she's not coming through. Or if you signed up for my email list. Sorry, the sun is really weird. I feel like the glare is being funny. I don't know. Probably not being very nice to me in the coloring. What, Lily? She's going, ah. Probably because I look bad. Yes, Sally, you did share. Yes, you did. I got your name in here at least twice, I think you shared. So you have at least two entries in here, and that's the same for anybody. As many times as you share, say hello. Oh, she's like stomping by. Nice. Okay. Typical teenage girl right there, ladies. I know you've all experienced it, right? Hi, Carolyn. How are you? All right. Okay, so here we go. Here we are drawing for the Absolutely Argyle Embossing Folder, sharing and signing up for my email list. And the winner is Miss Debbie Green. All right. Oop, there we go. Congratulations, Miss Debbie. So I will get you your Absolutely Argyle Embossing Folder. I get that sent out to you. Yeah, Sally, you saw her. Yeah, and that's it. That's all you're going to see of her now, I think, unless she needs to come back down and get some lunch. So, okay. So yeah, in case you're wondering too, Lily has she goes to school in the morning at regular time, but then she has two online classes in the afternoon. So she gets to come home like for lunch, and then she does the online classes that she does from home. So she has a really like short day at school, which is kind of interesting, but that's how it's working this year, or this trimester, I guess we should say. So yeah, so she's not skipping school, really. She's home and will do her work from home now. So you guys are cute with your congratulations. Okay, so next Facebook Live, which I will tell you, I'm actually going to be out of town next week for a few days, like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday through the weekend. So I won't be able to do Facebook Live next week. I'm going to Memphis, actually. I have a friend of mine, kind of my boyfriend. I don't know if we're calling each other that yet or not. But anyway, he lives in Memphis, so I get to go down and visit him. I've not been there before, so I'm kind of excited to go down and see what Memphis is all about. But anyway, so we won't be doing Facebook Live next Friday. I'll be live back on, I think it's October 2nd. Will be the next Facebook Live. So when we get back to Facebook Live, we will be drawing for, yeah, you were wondering what Lily was up to, right? Yeah, so this is the Mint Macaron, the Basket Weave Embossing Folder, or I'm not embossing folder, but Basket Weave Ribbon. So the Mint Macaron Basket Weave Ribbon right here. This is what we'll be drawing for if you share the video, right? And if you're new to me and have not signed up for my email list, if you do that, the link will be in the details to this YouTube or Facebook Live video after I edit it, after we're done today too. And I think pretty much on every email I ever send, there's Well, I guess if you get my email, you're already on my email list, right? Anyway, you can sign up for my email list on my blog too. I know there's a link there also at gatheringinspiration.com. So hello, Beth. Welcome. Glad you can join us. I'll be seeing you soon at card class too. That's the other reason I'm talking really fast, because I got to make sure I get done with this so I can get down to card class in just a little while too. So, okay. All right. So this is what we'll draw for. So this is part of, I pulled apart because I think I used a bunch of the metallic ribbon, so I had some extra. This is the basket weave, so part of the kind of fall ribbon collection, the mint macaron basket weave ribbon. Okay, so all right, what else? Ooh, we want to welcome a couple of new demonstrators who actually, hello Lori, be seeing you soon too at class. New demonstrators who just got the starter kit. They became Inkspired Stampers this month in September. So we want to welcome Susie Meekumber and Sandy Johnson to our Inkspired Stampers group. So congratulations, ladies. You got that awesome starter kit deal, and now you're a part of our Inkspired Stampers group. So welcome. Welcome, ladies. We're glad to have you be a part of things. So, okay, so the next thing, quick reminder, I kind of mentioned it already, so the 50th birthday special, right? I'm giving away a Stampin Cut and Emboss Machine, right? So here, I've got it all like opened up, but right, this hot little number could be your, not this exact one, I'm gonna give you a brand new one that hasn't even been opened yet, right? So if you put an online order in of at least $50 and use the host code that is always on my blog at gatheringinspiration.com, and I will give it to you in just a little bit, use that host code, put your order in of at least $50, you automatically get either the Demo Design Dream Team PDF tutorial or the free embellishment for September, which are the iridescent pearls. Super awesome package of pearls. They're kind of part of the Halloween collection, but as I'm looking at them right now, I see like purple, blue, green, pink, lots of different colors on here. You can't see them very well in the video, I don't think, but anyway, they're awesome. So you can pick. $50 order automatically gets you either the PDF tutorial or the embellishment. You also, if you ordered between Wednesday of this week and Facebook Live on September 4th, you also automatically get both of these cards sent to you in your thank you package. And then also your name's going to go in the drawing to win that new Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine. So same thing applies now, right? You get the PDF tutorial, 16 projects, or the free embellishment, free with your $50 order for sure. You get the cards I'm going to demonstrate next, and your name goes in the drawing to win the Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine. So that's from now until September 30th, through the end of the month. And we will do that drawing for the winner of the new Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine. I'll do that on our October 2nd Facebook Live. So that'll be our next one. I know, it's kind of crazy. This month has been nutty. I'm chalking it up to like 50th birthday. Like, I'm basically celebrating all month long, ladies. You know, right? Don't you get to do that when you turn 50? That's like a big deal, right? I'm saying it is anyway. So I made it. How about that? Okay. All right. I think we are good. Another just quick reminder, because the weekend retreat is coming up in Lansing on October 23rd, 23, 24, 25. Okay. If you RSVP and pay, you can pay through PayPal. If you do that by this Monday, is that right? Yeah, this Monday, September 21st, you get an extra free gift in your goodie bag, okay? And then final RSVPs for the weekend retreat are due by October 2nd. So that's that in a couple Fridays from now, 2 weeks from today, actually. I need final RSVPs for the weekend retreat. So I'd love to have you come hang out with me all weekend long. We spoil you, we feed you, we take great care of you. Basically, you can be in your PJs and slippers all weekend long if you want to, crafting and having fun. We have games, we have like music, we have movies. It's all kind of in the background though. So if you want to just be super focused, or you bring your earbuds and do your own thing, you can be social if you want. You can be like super focused and like just be a workhorse and get as much done as you want, or some version of in between. We love everyone to be there and just do whatever you want to do to enjoy your weekend. So we'd love to have you be a part of it too, okay? And then one day retreat, I can't remember all the details, but I do know that it's on November 14th. So right here in Alma, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. You have a little bit longer for your free gift RSVP and final RSVPs, but check your calendar out. I know people are starting to like think about all that stuff. We will be practicing good social distancing measures. We'll have all those in place too, so everybody should feel safe, right? So if you have any questions, I'd love to have you hang out with us for that weekend, October 23, 24, and 25. So it's coming up, ladies. It's like right around the corner at this point. So, okay. All right, I actually talked so fast, I think I can flip the camera down because I want to show you. I got some birthday cards I want to share with you guys and birthday packages too, which was so nice. You guys were super, super sweet and I felt the love. So thank you very much. And then we will do our, we'll make our projects with our Love of Leaves bundle. So hey, Becky, hello, hello. Thank you for sharing and welcome. Glad you can be here. Okay. I think, man, I talked really fast, didn't I? Yeah, okay, this is good, I'm doing well, yeah. Okay, so we're gonna flip the camera down and I will show you some of my fun birthday cards, okay? And then we'll do our stamping. Okay, so turn your heads away for a sec. We're gonna fly through the air and get set up to see what's next, ladies. Okay, there. So here's our product of the week, that Love of Leaves bundle. You know what I forgot to do, and I'm pretty sure it's right here, but I just want to make sure. Let me give you the host code right now while I'm thinking about it. And I'm also looking because I feel like all that was going to take a lot longer than I thought. So now I'm going to do a quick double check and make sure that I told you guys about everything. But this is the host code you want to use through the end of the month, the 42SF4JVE. You can always find that on my blog too at Gathering Ink with a K, gatheringinspiration.com. Okay, so real quick, I'm going to just make sure, because I feel like I missed something, but I don't know. I think I was just so good. Very efficient. Can you guys keep up with me? And like I'm mispronouncing many words because I get too excited and talk too fast. Hey, Vina. Hello. And hey, Sandy. Glad you guys can join us. All right. I think we're good. Yeah. All right. I was just fast. Okay. I'm trying to decide, put my glasses on. I think I'm gonna, since you guys can't see me now. So let's see how funny maybe I look, right? Okay. 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 Let's do it. Okay. So here, how many times can you say, okay, in one, in one Facebook Live or in one like minute long segment of Facebook Live? Okay. So check this card out. Isn't this fun? So love the bright, this is my favorite pattern too in that Flowers for Every Season Designer Series paper. And then this is fun too, because she used the in color Designer Series paper. And I love that. Happy wishes. The best part is the fold on this card. So can you check this out? Woo! Right? How about that? Birthdays are the best days. And this is from Miss Sharon. Happy birthday, Amy. Love, Sharon. Thank you, Sharon. I loved this card. Now, I'm going to maybe not fold it back up the right way. Look at that glare. Yes, the sun is low these days, isn't it? Okay. And the breeze is blowing a little bit. So we've got, there we go. See if that'll do it for now for a little bit. So here's another fun card. This one is from my friend Stacy that lives in Chicago. That was a cute card, wasn't it? And these, I love. This is, I think, I'm trying to remember. This is retired paper, so I can't even quite remember the name of it. It's amazing how those names come and go from your mind. But she did a cute. It's a beautiful day to turn 50. Hope you have the best birthday ever. Love, Stacy. Thanks, Sharon. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Such a cute card. And then here's another fun one. Right? I love the pink too, the pink sunflower with the green. Pink and green is just kind of a fun, like preppy kind of color combination too, right? And then with the embossing folder, that ornate floral. Love this one, right? Amy, I hope your birthday was super. It wasn't really very late, but that's cute, right? Sorry, this is late. Love, Sunday. So thank you, Sunday. This was an awesome. I love that card too. And look at like the little detail there. Yeah, so many cute cards, right, Vina? Okay, now this one is fun because of the envelope too. So if you guys haven't seen, look at that, isn't that, oop, let me cover that up, right? I'm trying not to show people's addresses just to be safe. But look at, so yeah, I love this envelope though, right? So the coordinating envelopes, and now I'm trying to remember because this was actually a product of the week a little bit ago, and I'm totally, it's like the perfect posies stamp set. and like the posy card kit. So you get kind of all the parts and pieces to make this beautiful card, and then you get the cool coordinating envelopes too, right? So fun birthday wishes. Enjoy your special day. Love, Philomena. And I love how she decorated the inside too, because I got into that for a little while and I've gotten out of it, and I need to get back into it because I love kind of adding just that little bit of detail there too. So, okay. And then here's another birthday card. Love the, right, all of the beautiful kind of fall theme to the colors too, right? It's a happy day. And then this is cute. Hope you have a wonderful 50th birthday. Celebrate. Love, Jamie Sanders. And so she gave this, I think this is kind of fun too. I like to do this also. So she just wrote on this so that maybe I could use this card again and re-gift it. It says, wishing you warmth and sunshine. And Jamie did a great job. I love like just using that designer series paper on the inside and then that little strip there too. It was probably like an extra little piece she had on the edge here, right, of this one. And she just used a little strip of it on the inside too. So super cute, right? Then I have a couple of, let's see here. Can I put this whole, I kept it right in here. Yes, I know. I love that on the inside too, Lisa. I'm going to have to remember that also. So this was a fun little gift box that I received. So we'll check out the card here because this was a beautiful, isn't this so, it's like a little barrel of apples, right? And I thought maybe it didn't. I thought it opened. Am I crazy? Oh, it opens right here. I was trying to open the little flap. This part doesn't open, but this is cute, right? Amy, happy birthday. This is from Teresa, who I think is watching right now. So, so cute. I loved those apples, that whole Harvest Hello sweet, right? I love that. And I love how she did the embossing here too. Looks like maybe she did a little bit of sponging, right? Wishing you a happy birthday. So, so cute, right? Isn't that fun? And then look what she made. She was telling me where she found these things. So she found the card on Pinterest from Jennifer Merle Hampshire, which is whispersinink.net. And then she had a video that she made. She used the Harvest Hellos from last year, along with the punch. And then the leaf, oh, she's so cute. She's like, the leaf trinkets are from last year. And then the mini curvy keepsake box dies, which you guys have to see. Because check out these fun little, these are the cutest little, and she packed them up so nicely too. Oops, and now that little bit's getting caught on there. But look at how cute these things are. This little, so, so, so cute. And it says, hey there, pumpkin, on the inside, right, with the twine. Aren't these so cute? Look at these. So she did an orange one and then a cute little, so pumpkin pie, right? We've got a real red one right there. And then I'm going to say this is Granny Apple Green, I think. Yeah, and so the stamping and the punching, aren't those so cute? And then she gave me a couple hand sanitizers, which I can always use. I was running out in my car, so I'm like, perfect. I'm going to have to, I kept these in here, but now I'm going to take those out and put a couple of them in my car because you can always use more of those, right? But so cute, right? Here, can we get that a little bit better into view? So just, it was such a fun little, a little box of goodness to open up. And then you can see how the card, look at everything coordinates so beautifully too, right? So thank you, Teresa. Loved that fun little box of goodies. Truly appreciate that. And then I've got one more fun thing to show you guys. So let's see, I've got another box of goody and goodness. And this card blew me away because look at all of the detail on here. And she's so like precise with it all too. I thought this, she took a lot of care and effort and time to get everything. I don't have this die set, so maybe it's easier than I think, but it looks like, Teresa, yes, I'm so glad you're on. Thank you, thank you, thank you. But yeah, I love the colors too. These blue and yellow, right? I'm like a Michigan fan, so maize and blue is always awesome. And then just the sunflowers too. So with the happy birthday and the little in-color dots. And then I love how she did the inside. Another great example of how to decorate the inside of your card. Amy, wishing you the best on your special day. Have a great birthday weekend from Monica. And then I have to show you, what did she do inside here, right? So check this out, ladies. This blew me away also. Like check, oops, here we go. Do this. It's like a little home decor thing. Isn't this so cute? And of course, it coordinates too, right? The card and the little home decor piece. Such pretty cards. I agree. Yes. So, and I love this. Friends are the flowers in the garden of life. And she used a bunch of our new, right? Our new flowers for every season. The designer series paper right there. The ribbon right there. the vase with the cute little flowers. So isn't that, oh, it's just so pretty. Love this. So much good detail on here too. And what a cute, cute piece. I can't decide whether I want to take this down to the stamp studio or whether I want to keep it at home. I want to share it with everybody. So I'm showing you guys here. And obviously more people would see it at the studio, but I don't know. I think I might need to keep it here at home too. So thank you, Miss Monica. I appreciate that. So, okay. All right, now, ladies, I think we are good. Moving on, we can start our stamping. Okay, so let's scoop these things up and out of the way. So, actually, let's see. That one, I think I wasn't very good the last time I did Facebook Live to make sure I was in view well. So there, that looks like we're in view. Now I know where you guys can see everything, right? Okay, so first card is a fun, this is a case from the catalog. And thank you guys, everyone. Everyone was just, it was so nice, so fun to receive all of your cards. So I appreciate every single one of you thinking of me. So thank you. I'm like saying thank you, thank you, thank you. So, okay, so this card, fun case of our August to December mini catalog. I don't know why. I really think we need to get Stampin' Up to come up with another name for our catalog, because that's too many words to say. I'm like, I want to say holiday catalog because it's so much easier. But anyway, and I loved, and I think I posted this earlier this week on our Facebook group, I just loved the super like non-traditional colors that they used on this card. And there was some kind of some fun. They actually went even crazier. They did like some splattering on the card too. So on like this crumb cake piece, they did some kind of with white craft ink, I think. And I wasn't, I think what they used are our new, we used to have aqua painters, but now they're like water painters or something. And I didn't have those yet. So I was like, oh, I don't think I should use my aqua painters because we don't have those anymore. But I think they kind of flicked ink, like white craft ink, to kind of make it look splattery on this piece also, which was very cool in the catalog. But this is my version of this card. So we are gonna go ahead and make this little baby here. So let's get our ink. And I think I did do some of the stamping and die cutting ahead of time, because as you can see, we need two of these long leaves, two of these, and then one of each of those, actually kind of two of those blue ones there too. So that was kind of, there's a lot to it. So I did do some of it already, but I left some of it to show you guys what I did as well. So let's see, let me get these. So this one goes in there, that one goes there. This one I think I did already, so we don't need. We got the pink and the yellow. Okay. So, let's see. I will tell you that I started with a crumb cake card base. Right? That, here we go. Oops. Or piece of crumb cake cardstock, I guess I'll say, right? I feel like I'm not straight, but maybe my camera's crooked. So it just looks like my grid paper is not straight either. Okay, so here we go. We have our, along the 11 inch side, we cut it at 5.5 inches. And then along the 8.5 inch side, we scored it at 4.25 inches. So there's our nice crisp fold on our card, right? Just like that is how we're gonna make that. Then we also have another piece of crumb cake cardstock that measures 4 inches by 5.25 inches, okay? And then everything else is just scrap. I need scrap Whisper White cardstock. And these are some of the leaves that I've already created. And I wanna show you how I did this. So if you can kind of see in the right light, so this is Pear Pizzazz ink, and I used a little bit of my Champagne Mist Shimmer Paint. And I'm gonna show you how I did that. Just to add a little bit of shimmery goodness. Can you kind of see if I hold those up? I don't know, you can kind of see the little shimmery. So Stampin' Up! Will give us basically like the recipe, all of the products that they used in the catalog to make this card. And they mentioned the Champagne Mist Shimmer Paint. I was like, oh, that's fun. I haven't used that in a long time. So let me show you the idea. And what I almost have to do this for myself. I have to make sure so I make enough of what I need. So I've got that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. Okay, so I need to do one pink. So let's see, we're gonna do Magenta Madness first. I know the colors are awesome, aren't they? Was that Philomena? You guys are all, hi Sue in Ohio. So glad you guys can join us. Okay, so Magenta Madness is what we're using on that long pink leaf. Then we have, ooh, super bright now. Okay, then we have some Bumblebee ink with our other. There we go. And then I just need a little, just for this little tip right here. Oops, excuse me. Sorry, I just bumped the camera mount there, didn't I? All right, things are going everywhere. We are going to just do this. Actually, here we'll go like right there with that one is all we need there. And then one more do I need, right? I've got one, two. Oh, yeah, the green. Okay. So we don't need that. Okay. So we're going to use our little leaf. Oh, what did I do with my little leaf? Oh, right here. Okay. Got my little baby leaf. I'm going to just put it on this one because I'm not sure I have room. So we've got that one. And then we're also going to do our sentiment. So this is Pear Pizzazz ink, if I didn't say that already. Let's go ahead and stamp our sentiment right on here also. There. Okay. All right. So I think we've got all of our stamping. We can, let's go ahead and punch that out. We're going to use a 1.5 inch circle punch, and it just barely fits around our "Your friendship is something I can count on" sentiment. Okay, so we've got that. And actually, I'm just going to kind of pull this off. Okay, let's get these things over here. Okay, let me grab my new Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine. Does everybody have one of these yet? Oh, it was so fun. It was like the upgrade, you know, like when you get a new car or something. That's kind of how I was feeling about this Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine. Like my other Big Shot, it's fine. But this one, just fun, fancy, new, something to play with. I'm going to cut these apart just so, you know, when they're moving around on here, it'll be a little bit easier. Okay, so to do our die cutting, grab these dies. Okay, so we're going to put one there, one there, one there, one here. Okay. So now, hopefully everything cooperates with me. You can see on the card that I made, things winged away a little bit. It just seems to happen. I didn't even realize it until I laid my plate down. But we're gonna see, man, that sun gets so bright sometimes. I don't know, can you guys tell? I think you can, can't you? Thank you for sharing, Sue. I appreciate that so very much. Okay, I'm getting all these lined up. So you can see, oh, you know what I forgot to do, but we'll do it in a sec. I forgot to add the champagne mist shimmer paint. We'll do that in a sec. We can do that after we cut these. Since I already spent all this time getting it set up, I don't want to take them off and put that on and then put them back on my platform here, because that would just be so much work. So we will. Actually, what I'll do is I'm going to put them on that grid paper. Okay, that one, that one, that one, and then that little bit right there. Okay, so now we can sponge our champagne mist shimmer paint. Got all excited about the stamping and I forgot to do that. So we're just gonna put those right in there in case I go off the edges at all, which you might, and that's not a problem. Okay, so I have a sponge dauber that I just keep in here, because it already has champagne mist shimmer paint on it. So we're just gonna put that there. Just gonna shake this up. It's got a little ball in there too. And what I'm trying to do is just get some ink down into the cap here. So that when I open this up, I can just daub in there. And maybe I'll just put a little, I just kind of like to sponge around a little bit and kind of go back, because that first little daub has maybe more ink on it than you want. So if you just kind of keep daubering, is that a verb? If you keep daubering around on your leaves, you can kind of get it all spread out. And it just adds just a little bit of shimmer, you know, almost like maybe something you'd see like truly on leaves, like, you know, once they've fallen. So there we go. That's all you do. And then just take that off your finger. I'm going to set it aside to let it maybe dry a little bit before I put it back in my baggie, just so it doesn't get ink all over the place. But that's basically it, okay? So if you can you kind of see just a little bit of shimmeriness on those? We're gonna let those dry just a bit. And let's see, I'm gonna grab this piece here. Okay, so now I'm gonna flip these babies over. These are the first ones that I made. We'll start with these while the other ones are Oh my gosh, you know what I forgot to do? Is it a verb? It is now. Sharon, I forgot to do the embossing. When I flip these over, I'm like, how come these look so much better? Because I didn't do the insides of these. Oh, how, you guys, didn't you, nobody caught that? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, we're going to have to go back and do those. Okay, we're going to let those dry. Okay, so yeah, don't do it the way I've done it here today, ladies. Okay. Oh my gosh. All right. But we have to add, that's the best part, is all that stitching, right? I went on and on about that when we were first talking about things. Okay. Well, we're doing this in a funny order, and that's just how it's going to be today, ladies. Okay. So those are probably going to be pretty dry, hopefully. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I did that. Well, I guess I can, you know, whatever. Okay. So here we go. We are going to add that one maybe right about there. So this is the fun part. You just kind of place these on here, and we're going to snip them all off in a little bit. So this one, maybe right about there. How do I want to do it? Maybe right about there, right? And then I'm going to put this pink one up inside there, and then one more green one. So then we'll just add a few more around the edge here. There, so I'm going to press pretty firmly. Okay, so those are the ones I already made. So let's finish up. Man, I can't believe I did that. Like I said, I almost can, but you know. Where's your brain, Amy? I don't know. It's like on vacation, I guess. Okay, so here. I'm going to grab all of these things and let's get these back on here. Okay, and we can add, so don't do it this way, ladies. Die cut and do the stitching, the embossing all at once. Okay, that one and one more. Can we get that guy right? There we go. Okay. Okay, yes, it's a verb. I'm still looking at that and laughing, Sharon. Yep, it's a verb. Daubering, sponge daubering. Let's see, how did we do? Oh, it's a million times better. Look at the detail on there now. Love it. Love it so much. Okay, I'm going to scoot those out of the way because I'm going to need some of those for our next card. Yeah, okay. Much, much, much better. Those are all kind of stuck on there. Okay, now we'll finish adding those to our card. Okay, so I'm going to flip these over, add some more adhesive to these things. That is not running, so we'll do that again. That one and that one and that. Okay, now where's my piece that I was working on? I'm looking at, I got to have my card in front of me though, so I know what I'm doing. So I'm going to lay this one maybe right about there. See, we'll do this one down here, that one right there, and that one. I feel like, does that need to come down a little bit? Oh, well, it's not gonna now. We'll just do that right there. Okay, so I'm gonna actually flip this over. I'm gonna press super firmly, because with that stitching or embossing on there, I think it makes it, you know, they don't wanna stick quite as well. Okay, so now, there you go, Sharon. If I didn't screw up, right, no one would know how to do it right themselves. Good attitude. I like that. So now we are just gonna, makes me feel a little bit better too, right? Oh, well, and it's the beauty of live, right? Facebook Live. So just snipping off along the edges here. Okay. Oops. Things are going flying everywhere. There we go. And you know what? The kind of cool thing is if you snipped a little bit, because I think I did, of my crumb cake card base here, it's really not going to matter because we're going to lay this right on. Well, actually, I popped it up. That's my other new favorite thing to do, is instead of putting that right on there, I'm actually going to put dimensionals behind here. And if I had what they had suggested was using, we'll put a couple more. The foam strips, probably what I should have done. And I may have those. I just couldn't find them the other day. Is that bad? I am pretty organized, but for whatever reason, I couldn't find those. So, but you could use the strips. You could just do some strips all the way around. Instead, we're just going to use a bunch of dimensionals. So this is, like I said, my fun new thing to pop. I think I didn't. Did I get them all? That one's good. That one's good. That's it. Yep. There we go. Pop this whole thing up on the card base. Okay. So then you have to be careful because these dimensionals stick a little bit more quickly. But that's what I was saying. Even if you snipped a little bit of the edge, you're not even going to tell once you put it on because it's crumb cake on crumb cake, right? So then we have, this is the Flowers for Every Season ribbon combo pack. And I am just going to, what I did was I just ran some adhesive and kind of like looped it back and forth a little bit. So we're going to put that maybe right there. And I was kind of using this little guy is my guide so that I, because I don't want to make it so small that you barely see my ribbon. So I'm going to do that there. And then I think I need to add some more adhesive right back in there to actually make this do its thing there. And let's put a couple of, we're going to put some dimensionals behind our sentiment. Your friendship is something I know I can count on. Love that, right? This would be a great card, obviously, to send to a good friend. So we're going to put that maybe right there. And then I waited to trim it because I wanted to make sure that I liked what I had going there. And then final step, where are my? So these are the Artistry Blooms adhesive backed sequins. So you can see, I love all of the beautiful colors in here. So, and can it, I can't remember, but I don't know. I'm going to say Calypso Coral, maybe. I think these are Rich Razzleberry. Sorry, they're backwards. Rich Razzleberry and like a purple color. What are these? I don't know. Maybe Flirty Flamingo, I'm not even sure. And then these are a light blue. I'm gonna say Pool Party, but maybe Balmy Blue. I'm not exactly sure, but we're gonna use a couple of these little babies. Let's see, we're gonna just, they've got the glue dots right behind them. So we just make sure you kind of dig underneath there so that you actually get the glue dot off of the sheet. Otherwise you get the little sequin and no glue dot, and then they don't stick. So just adding a little bit of bling right there at the end to kind of finish those off. And there is our card. What do you guys think? Isn't that so pretty? Love, like the beautiful, like I said, non-traditional fall colors right there, right? So there's the other one. Love it, love it, love it. Thank you. Yeah, so not my idea. Like I said, I found it right in the Stampin' Up! Catalog. I love to do that, though, when I'm curious, you know, about, like, a project. How did they make that? Or I want to make that, too, because it's so pretty. So that's what we do. Okay, so we are going to clean these off just a little bit. Make sure, because I think, I don't know. I can't remember if I need any of these. I'm glad you like that. Thank you, ladies. I thought it was very pretty too. Fun, bright, it's like summer colors on a fall kind of theme type of card, right? Okay, there we go. Just using my Simply Chamois there. Can't use that enough, I don't think, right? Okay, so putting those over here. All right, I gotta get these ink pads out of the way, otherwise I'll probably try to use one of those colors on this next card. We don't wanna do that, right? Okay. So this one I found on Pinterest. I'm not going to take any credit for it. This is a case from a gal named Connie Babbert, and she is a demonstrator that I used to follow all the time. Like when I had card class, basically every month I'd go check out Connie's blog at Inkspired Treasures, I think it is. Did I write it down? Yep, Inkspired Treasures. So ink like me, gathering inspiration. Hers is Inkspired Treasures. So many cute ideas. I love so much of her work. And I kind of like, I lost touch with her. I hadn't like been over to her blog in a while. And I happened to see this card on Pinterest. And I was like, oh, Connie, what a beautiful, beautiful card. I think maybe she used some of the metallic ribbon and I didn't have any more of that. So I popped that little bit of color on there too. And she might have used some other bling on there too. But I loved, I think what it was the cinnamon cider. First of all, this piece of designer series paper is from the flowers for every season designer series paper. I thought this was so ugly. I was like, what am I ever going to do with that paper? So I think that was another part. I was like, Connie, she used it and I like it. So if you can kind of see, there's the backside of that flowers for every season, but I don't know, that just didn't do anything for me. And then she put it on this card and I was like, it's perfect. That's exactly how you should use that designer series paper. So, and I loved the stitching too. So this is kind of like that city skyline, only it's upside down. So I'll show you that when we make that one. But I loved this card. So I was like, okay, we're doing this one too. And we're making this at class today. That was the other reason that I'm doing it here on Facebook Live, because I knew I wanted to show everybody at class this cute card. And I'm like, wow, let's just show everybody on Facebook Live too. So thank you, Connie. I'm not trying to take any credit for your card. I just loved it and thought lots of people need to see this. So, okay, let me grab what we need here. Make sure I've got it all. We'll get our ink. These little babies. Okay, so let's get the card pieces. That's what I really need to be doing. Okay. Okay, so this time we are again starting with a crumb cake card base. This one is the, let's see, this time we went along the 8.5 inch side, we cut it at 4.25 inches, and then along the 11 inch side we scored it at 5.5 inches, and that one actually isn't even scored. Look at that too. I don't know what happened with this. I need to go grab my trimmer and my scorer in one thing, because we need to fix that up, and apparently I never actually scored this, so I'll be right back. So let's see, we're gonna pop this thing in here. We're gonna line this up at just a titch under, because I think I just want to trim the whole darn thing. Ooh, what is going on? It's almost like there's something on my card. Oh, look at that, I made a big mess of that. Okay, that's gonna be the back of the card. Don't worry about that, I'll fix that later, because I don't have another piece of card stuck right now. I'm not sure what I did there, but okay, let's score it. We're gonna score it at 5.5 inches. Okay. Yeah, weird. Okay, we'll figure that out later. Not worrying about it now. Okay, get all of this off of here. There. Okay, so that'll be our card front, okay? I know, Sue, I love it also. Here, this is what we're gonna do. This is bugging me. I gotta trim that off a little bit. There we go. Okay, that is good there. Now we also have a piece of cinnamon cider cardstock. This one, all right, let's just get that card base right out of the way, measures 4 inches by 5.25 inches, okay? And then everything else is scraps, other than we need one piece of crumb cake, that piece right there, that measures 3 inches by 4.25 inches, okay? So let's see, we've got a bunch of die cutting and embossing. Okay, so we're gonna just scoot that right up there. We only need to do this stamping though, so let's do that with this little I thought of you today. Cute, right? I thought of you today. Cute, cute, cute. Okay, so there we go. I thought of you today. And now we can do our die cutting. So let's do that. Okay, this one and this one. Where are all my dies now? Okay, so with our platform, we've got a few things we need to cut here, okay? So, oopsie daisy, this is a piece of cinnamon cider cardstock. Actually, let's pull it, maybe we'll pull it back here because we've got a number of things we need to die cut. Okay, so this time I am gonna remember to do both pieces. So we've got our cut around the outside and then the stitching on the inside. Then this is some of our awesome, this is like the brushed metallic paper in, I'm going to say copper and bronze. So we're going to lay these guys down here. We're going to do our leaves and our stitching. I threw them like over here from the last card, and now I got to figure out what do I need here. That one and that one, I think, right? Okay, so we're going to do that one on there, and that one on the inside, and then this one. This one looks like a heart to me, or a spade. Maybe more like a spade, right? From
cards. Okay, so you just have to kind of work these until they, and you know what, honestly, if the stitching isn't perfect, that's kind of all right too, because, you know, in nature, things aren't always perfect, are they? Okay, what else am I looking for? Oh, here, let me show you. So I wonder if we're going to be able to, we might have to do this separately. So these are the Tasteful Labels dies. We're going to use that little baby label right there. I'm forgetting, oops, it's in the back, Amy. Oh my goodness. Okay, here we go. What I was trying to figure out is if I have room, I think we're going to do it later. Actually, we'll do that one later too. Let's just do these three right here. So we got to run a couple of things. So we're going to do these. So sorry if it wiggles. Turn your heads away for a sec. So we're just doing the die cutting and then the stitching on the inside of the leaves with this one right here. Because then we have to do the other little bit. Okay, so how about that? Very good, right? And then we have this one. These. I've got to keep these organized to get them down to class too, so I don't forget anything. All right, this one and this one. So we have those there. Then here, this is what we want to do, the fun of, so let's put that one. Where's my card? I'm trying to make sure. I'm going to go that way on there. And then this is the one. So you're just going to lay this, like I said, doesn't it look like a city skyline? So we're just going to lay it, but upside down. We're going to lay it maybe right about like that. And we're going to, so this is just going to kind of emboss on there too. And then we've got this, I thought of you today, and this one like barely fits on here, but the stitching kind of goes around the edge too. So it's a little bit bigger than you think it is. When you're looking at it, you're like, it's not even going to fit that sentiment, but it did. I'll show you what I mean. See? Perfect, right? It just went around there. And then isn't that cool? So it looks like, again, looks like a city skyline almost there, right? Okay, so we got those. Next, we need to do our embossing. So let's get that out. We'll get our other embossed piece, and then we can put everything together. Okay, so we have, this is the Tasteful Textile Embossing Folder. Okay, and we are going to use that with our piece of cinnamon cider cardstock. Pop that in there. So I've got my platform number one, my 3D embossing folder, and then my, what is that, platform number four for the 3D embossing folders. Okay. That right through there. And I think we are ready to put things together. Okay. Woohoo! I love that. That Tasteful Textile Embossing Folder. Awesome stuff, right? Okay, so here we go. We can just add this one. Oops. I don't know where it goes. It's like as soon as you set it down, it curls itself back or something. I don't really understand, but it does seem like that happens. Okay, so we're going to put this piece right on here. Okay, and then we can add this one, and we're going to want to use quite a bit of, see, it like curled itself back away somewhere. I don't know. It's craziness because it was just running, right? It's running perfectly this whole time. Okay, so next we are going to add this one right about there, right? Very versatile. Yes, it sure is. Okay, we got this one right here. I'm going to put the DSP along the bottom like that. Then we need some dimensionals behind all of these things, except not that one. It looks like I didn't put anything behind that one. Okay, so we're going to put a couple of dimensionals behind this leaf. Okay, and that one, and our sentiment. Okay, so let's do this big leaf. I know the fall, it's like those tan, yeah, I think kind of a monochromatic almost, right, with just the tan colors. Okay, so we're going to put this one right here. We're just going to just add some adhesive. Actually, I'm going to put this sentiment on next, and then we'll kind of add the other things in around it. Okay, so we've got our I thought of you today can go right there. This one we're going to kind of tuck, and then when you have that leaf, maybe you just have to tear a little bit of it off so it will tuck under there closer where you wanted it. And we're going to peel this little baby off and let's kind of tuck that one. Maybe, oops, I kind of want that little, I want the little stem to stick out there. Tuck that one right there. And I like to kind of curl these up a little bit too. Right. And then a couple more just little details. We are going to add a bumblebee twill ribbon bow. Okay, come on, little piece there. Get that pulling through. Right, okay. Making our bow. Where are my scissors? Grab that one there. Okay. I did grab my glue dot. We're gonna put that maybe right about there. Right, I need to trim. I've did that at too much of an angle and it's bugging me. Do that one and that one. There we go. And then last step is to add a couple of our champagne rhinestones this time. So I'm going to do one big one, maybe right about there, and then we're going to use a couple of little baby ones. Okay. So we'll do one there and maybe one right there. And there we go. All right, ladies, what do you think? So we've got a couple of beautiful, right, fall I thought of you today cards, right? Love, love that stitching on there too, right? Okay, so quick recap is how I always like to end things off, right? And actually, this is a $50 order right now to get the projects that I demonstrated and the choice of the Demo Design Dream Team PDF tutorial or the free embellishment, excuse me, the iridescent pearls. And then your name also goes in the drawing to win the new Stampin Cut and Emboss Machine. $50 order, get your name in there, right? The other way you can get your name in the drawing for that Stampin Cut and Emboss Machine is if you buy the starter kit through me. So let me know if you guys have any questions. This is the host code you're going to want to use to order to get your name in the drawing to get these free projects, the PDF tutorial or the iridescent pearls. All right. Thank you guys so much for watching today. It was great to be back with you all. And then, like I said, don't forget, I'm not here next Friday, but the following Friday, which is on October 2nd, we'll be doing the drawing for the Stampin' Cut and Emboss Machine and having lots more fun with more awesome fall projects, right? So thanks, guys. Hope you have a great week or two, and we'll be back soon. I'll be on Facebook, though, all the next 2 weeks. So thank you guys so much. I'm so glad you could hang out with me. Bye, everybody. Have a good weekend.